Good morning children. So today in continuation I will teach you main principles of democracy. There are two principles that any definition of democracy includes. The first, all citizens wield the power to govern through their elected representatives and have equal access to power. And secondly, all citizens enjoy legitimized freedoms and liberties. The majority rule is often described as a characteristic feature of democracy. An essential process in representative democracy is competitive elections that should be fair and impartial. Freedom of political expression, freedom of speech, and freedom of press are essential so that citizens are able to vote in their personal interest. Second topic is the process of decision making. And in this process, we are having three organs. Number one is legislature, number two is executive, and number three is judiciary. In a democratic type of government like India, all the decisions are taken by the three organs of the government, and these three organs are legislature, executive, and judiciary. These carry all the work of the government. They work in accordance with the rules and regulations laid down by the Constitution of India. The legislature, the duty of the legislature is to make laws. The legislature is always responsible towards the citizen because one of the houses of the legislature is directly elected by the people through periodic elections. Its elected members are the representative of the people or citizens. The laws made by the legislature are implemented by the executive. But nowadays, the scenario has changed. Now, the executive actively leads in all decision-making policies and which are also approved by legislature later on. The executive, which is answerable to the people, takes major decisions relating to the functioning of the government. Any wrong decision taken by the executive may lead to downfall of the government before the completion of its tenure. The third organ of the government is judiciary. According to the Constitution of India, judiciary is independent in taking its decisions. It ensures the smooth working of the government. If the laws made or passed by the legislature are against the welfare of the people, then according to the constitutional provisions, the judiciary can declare these laws as illegal. Judiciary is free to control both law-making and law-implementing bodies. The Supreme Court of India is the apex judicial body in India. The process of decision-making is time-consuming, but it is well-balanced. Hence, it is widely accepted by the people. So for today, this much only. Thank you.